Hello, in this video, I'm going to give you an overview about the game gem tools here in Unity. So these tools were built in Houdini, and we can use the plugin to then use them in different game engines like Unity. The first tool I would like to show is the level from PSD tools. So this is a tool that can load in a PSD file, read different layers, and then generate a level based on that. As you can see here, we have some basic buildings here. You can use, of course, your own models, modular models. So this level is fully generated based on PSD file. So here is the example of the PSD file. So the gray area is the area that we could walk in. Other colors are basically for scattering around props. So you can see that you don't have to also draw perfectly. The tool will automatically clean up some of the drawings. This can be a quick tool to make levels. Another tool here to make levels is the level generator with the wave function collapse. So this tool uses the wave function collapse algorithm. So that basically means that we're going to have to fill in a certain pattern. So we're going to have to give it a pattern. And based on that pattern, it's going to then try to replicate the pattern over a larger area. So this is an example of a level you could build. So this should be a pattern you should build yourself. And then you plug it in the tool. Also very important to know that this is also quite low resolution. So as you can see, this is 20 pixels by 20 pixels, so don't take your usual 1K map. That would be way too much. Just take a very low resolution. Now for the tool, you don't necessarily need to use the wave function collapse, like you can disable this. And you can input custom shapes. So in here I inputted a box, and whenever I would move the box, it will automatically create a room there. So now if I'm moving the box, you can see that everything around the box will be a room. So what you could do is you could just block out your level with cubes, and then you can use some wave function collapse, then generate here other smaller rooms and areas. So you can specify areas that are important to the level and then generate the rest of it. This tool also uses a tile set. So to get the most out of the tool, you're going to also have to build a tile set. So in the project files, you will have these FBXs. So these are the 14 tile sets you will have to make. So you can just open them in any software, and then you can start modeling on top of them to then get the tile set you want for the level. Another tool for building levels is the platform tool. So this will give structures like this. You can control the platform tool either by this curve, so you could draw different areas you want to have as platform. Or what you could also do is you can input a box, like here you could like have this box area. And around this box there will be grass and also these stones created. So we can quickly go here in edit mode and start editing our curve. And as you can see, we can then easily expand on this platform. Another tool is the placement tool. So based on a line here, it will scatter a model. So in here, I plugged in this prefab, and you can see that it's just placing it on the line. So you can also see that we can have the height difference and so on. There are multiple options here further to have certain orientations and so on. You also have options to just click a surface and scatter on surface. Just a general tool to place objects around. Then here is a pipe tool. You can also use this as a cable. So it will be controlled by a line. So we can grab the line and move the cable around. There are also further more settings to then how many pipes should be, the radius and so on. So next up is here a modular wall tool. Again, here we have different styles, so we can have the wall style, a door, windows, borders, we can bend the model, we can have different colors, we can make this way bigger or smaller if you want that. So it's quite a flexible tool to create some modular walls. Then next up here is the quick tree generator. So this is a tree generator based on a line. So as you can see here, I have this line, and when I modify the line, our tree will then also be changed. So you can see that we can use this for very quick iterations on different trees and generate multiple trees. Then here's the edge damage tool. So this will convert a simple geometry, like here these boxes, these are just Unity boxes. It will use this as input and it will generate a mesh like this. So as you can see here, it will generate this edge damage effect, and it will also boolean the mesh together. This is also a very useful tool to build quick models for your scene, modular models like pillars, walls, a certain border, and so on. So it's a very useful tool to go from like a very blockout shape to then a more final shape. Then next up here is a foliage tool. With this foliage, so there are two stages. So we're going to first create the leaf, like what type of leaf would you like to see? And then you're going to have to step two is then sort of assigning and combining the leaf to create a foliage. So in here, you can, for example, make some simple grass. You can also make a fern. You can also here use this as an ivy generator. You can plug in a model. So in here, I combined it with the edge damage tool. So you can combine tools as well. And also the sphere you see here at the bottom is actually the starting point. So moving the sphere now around, you will see that we can change our starting point. So if you do it like this, we can then have it from the top. And then we have more settings here to further control the growth and so on. And the last tool here is the rock tool. So based on, again, inputs like cubes or other simple shapes, it will generate this rock shape. So let me quickly hide the tool. You can see that this was actually my input, just three simple boxes, and then it will generate this cool rock. So you could easily like block out a certain area with boxes and then have rocks scattered on them. Also a cool feature here is at the bottom, I have added support for actually some scattering of rocks. So it's also useful there. And that was it for the overview. I hope you're interested to using these tools and also to further, after the game jam, explore these tools even more. So thank you for watching.